Hi, curators. Welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica, and I am here to guide you through Arnold's aiToon Shader. If you want to convert your 3D models into our cartoon, this is a tutorial for you. In this tutorial, we're going to go over Arnold's aiToon Shader, go over its attributes, and convert Cora, the 3D model, into a 2D cartoon. If you're new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, Zebra, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in converting Cora into a cartoon. All right, here we have Cora. She is modeled, UV mapped, and textured. So now we're going to convert her into a cartoon. You will notice that she's fully smooth. She's not smooth previewed. I went to modify smooth and made sure that she has a high poly. Next, we're going to go right-click, assign a new material. And what we're going to do is select Arnold. And in that list, you can type in Toon. And we have an AI Toon. Now you'll notice that we have a variety of things, collapse, edge, and silhouette. And we're going to go to base and go to the tone map. Here's where we're going to write RGB, which will give us the RGB node in Arnold. And you can see that we also have, it's a ramp. So you can also type in ramp and you'll see the AI ramp RGB. Now, when you render, you're going to see that you can see her previous textures and she's looking very flat. But this is the fun part about the Toon Shader. If you hit play, you can see that the shadows are getting darker and has a harder edge. You can also change the interpolation to none, and that will also give you a nice strong edge. I'm going to go ahead and hit stop on the render, and I'm going to dock it to the side because I would like to see the render, my model, as well as the attribute editor. So I finagled it until I could get the Arnold render onto the side of Maya, right next to the outliner, and I collapsed the outliner because I want more space. I don't need the outliner just yet. I'm going to be able to select the mesh as well as see the render at the same time. Go ahead and label the AI Toon. I'm going to call it body underscore AI Toon. And next is going to be the color. You can crank up the weight to 1. And now that that's looking good, I'm going to take a snapshot. Click on the connection. Go to file. Click on the folder. And then we're going to grab the base color. Now this is the accessory. There's the body base color. And it doesn't look like much happened. But we're going to go ahead and hit play, and you can see now that we have this really nice Toon shading. Now, the issue is the background. The background's really black, so we can't see the texture. So in your render settings, go to the Arnold tab, go to Background Legacy, and choose Create Sky Shader, and you'll see that the background color changes. So now we can see the dramatic color. Now, if you want to, you can change the AI sky to a different color, but in this scenario, I think the white looks the best in this case. So let's go ahead and start focusing on other aspects of the tone map. You can actually change the color of the shadow by, instead of having it black, you can change it to blue, which makes it a little bit more cartoon-like. So instead of being pitch black, it gives the shadow a bit of a color. But now we're starting to get that cartoon feel. Next, we're going to start working on the rest of the character. So I'm going to select her face. That includes her hair, her face, but it does not include all the accessories, nor does it include the eye. So I'm going to bring out the outliner, because I want to deselect the eye group. As you can see here, and then I have everything selected that I need. Once again, I'm going to right-click, assign a new material, go to AI Toon, and I got a little glitch on my render window, so I'm going to tear it off, close it, and take a look at the AI Toon. So once again, I'm going to go to File, Folder. I'm going to go in my Substance Painter folder, which all my Substance Painter textures are from. I'm going to go back and as well choose a tone map. So this is what we currently have, which is looking, you know, nothing major. But the tone map is the one that really adds to the AI Toon. I'm going to scoot it aside. Again, I'm going to choose Ramp, AI Ramp RGB. Bring those closer together. And in this one, I'm going to change the color to a little bit of a darker brown. So instead, again, of black, I'm going to get a nice dark shader. Bring those two colored swatches together. And it's up to you what type of color you would like. But that gives you, right away, a really cool looking Toon shader look. What's really great about the AI Toon is that it reacts to camera motion. So you get a really fancy look. Now, part of the magic is actually the lighting. So I deleted the sky dome and created a directional light. So create light directional light. I'm going to scale it. You can see you don't see it. It's because I actually hit all the lights. So you can go and unhide them under the show in the perspective window. And you'll see that because the light doesn't seem to be working very well. And that's because it's using Arnold and you need to increase the intensity. So I'm going to crank it up to 10, and that's probably too much. So let's go ahead and change it to 5. And you can see the tune shader is affecting. Now, as you notice, the accessories still need to be done. So that's going to be next. But it's really looking a lot better now that we have this directional light. It's just looking great. I'm going to go ahead and stop the render and work on the accessories. I do have my objects in a group except for the hair accessories. So I'm going to go ahead and select the hair accessories. Again, I'm going to assign a new material, aiToon. Let's go to base color, find the file, go to the folder, and look for the accessories. Again, we're going to choose the tone map. You can type in ramp to find the AI ramp RPG, RGB, not RPG, and then choose the color that you would like. Let's give that a look. And now all the accessories and all of Cora is now looking like a 2D cartoon, which is really cool and really fast. Now, the fun thing is that we can actually push this a little bit further. We can add highlights to the aiToon. So right now it's basically two tones. You have the texture map and then the shadows, but you can also add specularity. Before we tackle that, let's go ahead and make this look like more of a cartoon, which means that let's work on the outlines, right? So we can't really see the outlines here. I'm going to show you a fancy way of getting outlines. Make sure you select your full model. I don't want the eyes though. I'm just leaving it alone. So under rendering, we're going to go to tune and we're going to go to assign outline, add new outline. And it looks like it's there. But when we render, you're going to notice that it doesn't show up as an outline. And part of that is because this is considered a paint effect. So you can see in the outliner, we have something called PFX tune. We're going to go to modify, convert paint effects to polygons. And then we can now have an outline. And it's also still interactive. So I can go to the attribute editor and make the line width like 0.05, and you can control the line width. I'm also going to turn intersecting lines so it gives an outline along other pieces of the model. So it's really up to you how thick you want the line to be and how thin you want the line to be. You can make it really, really large, or you can make it as thin and thick as you like. So now it's really starting to look like a cartoon because it's got that outline. Now there is this thing called the line end thinning, which is really fun because it will actually thin the lines for you. And it can add a little bit more depth to your render. There's a variety of other things that I recommend you play with. You can play with the profile line width. You can play with the crease lines. And there's a whole range of attributes that you can use in the aiToon. That's beyond the scope of the tutorial, but I do encourage you guys to kind of play around and see if you can get some really fun results with the shader. And the list goes on and on. You'll notice that we have a paint effect. We have an offset mesh. We also have borderlines, such as open edge, shader boundaries, and a variety of things. So again, explore. That's the whole point of 3D, is to explore these attributes, see what the effects are, and then go from there. I prefer the defaults of paint effects and open edge. And there she is. Now, part of the issue is that as you zoom closer, the lines become thick. They don't change based on camera. So depending on your scene, you might have to change the line width depending on when your renders are. So for example, in this case, if I was getting a really close up of Cora, I might change the lines to something like 0.03. If I was doing a far away look, then I would use a line width of something thicker so you can see the outline. So again, it's depending on shot to shot. All right. As you can see, I can't really select the geometry because I have to hide the effects. So in the outliner, control H, the PFX tune, and now you can select the mesh. All right, let's push this a little further. Let's select the mesh for the face. The other thing that we can add is specularity. So under base, there's specularity. You can crank it up and you'll see that it kind of covers it in like reflective, but you can increase the roughness and you can get a nice little highlight. Now, once again, we have to drive this through a tone app. But just to show you, anastropy works in this. So you can get the nice thin line if you want to, and then you can rotate it. So you can crank up anisotropy, and then you can rotate it. I always find this really amusing. So just to kind of demonstrate to you that it can do some sort of metalness. Unnecessary, of course, in this case, but still fun to look at. Let's go ahead and grab the Arnold AI Ramp RGB. Arnold works better with the AI Arnold shaders that it provides. So go ahead and use the AI Ramp. Choose none. and you can see the effect that is starting to look very cartoony, which is beautiful. We can control this through the weight. As you can see, it's overwhelming it. So we can change the color, we can reduce the weight, and then we can play with the roughness until you get the look that you want. So for me, I feel like the roughness is a little too much, that the color might need to be a little bit more gray. And then you can kind of, you can play with these attributes to show you how big or how small that specularity is. But again, the effect is that it looks like a toon shader. It gives it a look that there's a highlight spot, there is the midtones, and then we also have the shadows. Cool. We're going to do the same thing for the body. Now, I like to keep things the same. So the weight for the face was 0.1 and the roughness was about 0.3. So I'm going to type in 0.1 for the body specularity and the roughness is 0.394. And I just want to make sure that everything's looking about the same. So I just want to compare the two. So the color is going to be a little bit grayer. And of course, I'm going to add the tone map. So once again, grab the Arnold AI Ramp RPG, bring those colors closer together so that you can get the effect. Now you can barely see it, but it's there. So you can kind of manipulate the ramp so that you can see that highlight a bit more or not. Oh, I flipped the colors by accident. And now you can see a little bit of that highlight, which I like. So again, you can increase the color and make it a little bit more cartoony. It's a balance, just like everything. If you like, you can change the highlight color. That can make it more interesting to look at. It's an option. You don't have to. But again, it's kind of fun to explore these type of values. So instead of just having gray on top of your shader color, you can actually change the shader color as well. So again, totally up to you what type of look you want to go for. So I'm going to bring the tone maps a little closer to the right so I can get a more dramatic look. And you can see the effect. Not a big fan of the blue on the skin, so I'm going to go ahead and bring it back to gray. Fun. All right. Again, let's go to the accessories. Let's add in the 0.1 for the weight, 0.4 for the roughness. Make that a little bit gray. Plug in a tone map. Grab the AI Ramp RGB. Bring those values close together. And you can see the effect on her accessories. And there you go. You get the highlight, you get the midtones, you get the shadows, and that's how you can create a cartoon looking Korra. Now I'm going to go ahead and select the light and go to the channel box and rotate it manually by middle mouse and dragging. And you can see how it affects the shadows. And it's really a fun effect to see how the cartoon shader gets affected by the light. Cool. It's looking really nice. Select the body, click on F to focus. And there we have Korra in all her glory. Click 1-1 because I have an HD 1080 render. And now we can see how the render looks like. And that's how you can make a cartoon shader for a 3D model using the aiToon in Arnold. It's a lot of fun, is relatively easy, and it reacts to the camera as you rotate it. So there you go. Let me know what you think. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like this content and that you want to see more. If you feel like an artist just like you could use this tutorial, please share. That would help me with the YouTube algorithm and other artists just like you. Don't forget to take a look at Academic Phoenix Plus. There you can find free content such as 3D models, eBooks, reference images, and so much more. And there you can also find some e-courses. So if you want a deep dive into Maya in modeling, texturing, and rendering, take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I have one little question for you. Do you recognize the background? If you do, leave a comment below. You'll get a little medal if you get it right.